This is Crisis here once again, coming to you live outside my bedroom and outside my house here. It has begun. The Xbox One fanboys are circling the wagons here again. They're trying to do a movement with the China release of Xbox One in China. I wish it very well, but I know the Xbox One is going to have a lot more problems than it does. First off, to me, the Xbox One had problems first day one it came out. Be like, well, you can't talk about those against the rules. You're a Sony pony. No, it's called being a consumer and being ticked off when a company says, no used games, no this, no that, and it's 24 plugged all the time. 24 hours, 8 times a week. And that's something that's wrong with me. I don't believe that. So they could check in and fix it up. And that's fine. They say, hey, we want to make sure that people ain't modding or cheating the games. Keep plugged in. Okay. You're not going to understand that. But when they say, you know, it's plugged in. And people in China are buying the Xbox One because they haven't had a console yet. They haven't had a console in like 30, 40 years probably. Maybe Atari. Maybe they even had Atari at all. I don't even know China know what Atari is. My hope for people in China is, if you get your hands on Atari, get it. Television, a 3DO, these old consoles, get a hold of it, and just admire the old school of them. Just admire the simplicity, but the challenging these games bring. Games nowadays don't have challenge anymore. But it doesn't mean it's not fun. My biggest complaint is about this new China thing is that when PS4 comes out, it may blow away Xbox again. May not. Don't know. But it's past any indication of what happened in the future. The next box is going to be dominated in China, and I hope they get them. You know they rain down enough micro dollars to get China on their side. Any way they have to make Chinese games, what do they got to do? Because once PS4 gets in there, and they will get an event to get in there, you're going to see a big shift, and you're going to see it big, just like with UK. And also, there's another price that Xbox One has released in our price drop for UK Xbox One. Not for the United States, not for Thailand or Japan or China, but only for UK. Is Xbox One done? Yeah, it's safe to say it's pretty much one done right now. Because you're dealing with the company now that has gone the way of the dodo from gaming. They literally went to TV sports realm and totally put gaming out of its misery. And I'm like, what the heck is gaming? I don't care about the apps, the new Windows 10. I don't care about it. I don't care about being able to watch TV and play games on my phone to my Xbox One. I don't care about the crap. I don't even care about the PS, PlayStation, TV. All I want to do is play games. That probably has 700 to 1,000 games downloaded on it. PlayStation TV. PS3, PS1, and PS2 games already downloaded on it. And, I've heard you can play PS4 games through it. Wi-Fi. Good or not, I don't know for sure. I don't even care. But, for $100, hey. People can afford it, get it. I'm not getting it anytime soon because I don't need it. But, you know. Stuff like that, you know, with this TV crap coming out, Sony's getting off the way. Sony's doing it correctly in my mind. I had to wait about a year to actually get going with this, and that's cool. They waited about a year to come out with their own TV thing. Now, they come out with their own cable network, don't know for sure. But if they do, it'd be kind of cool. watch TV on your PlayStation 4. 3 TV when watching TV. But it's not as funny as the Xbox version was. Play your TV on your TV, we watch TV through your TV. And that's funny, because that's the biggest knock on Xbox there would have been. And it's funny, because you know, I own an Xbox One, and I know that Xbox One could do better than this. Because, I'll look at the apps. I have to reset my Xbox One every time, just to get it to do certain things. To check my subscriptions, to check my account. I have to reset them every Xbox every time. I mean, completely turning it off and draining it of power, shutting down and reactivating all over again. It took me about 2 minutes to go up and reboot again. Two minutes for just check my apps, because some fork and spoon in Microsoft engineers can't figure this thing out. You know, and yeah, they come on, with new back walls and PS4 and you get new crap like this and Xbox. I don't care about that crap. Granted, no, I had back wall on PS3 of Uncharted 2 and Uncharted 3. But that's because that was themed and that was cool. Now I just want games. Games and more games. I don't care about the overallness of football TV. Watching on my cable box is what it's used for. And then I know the Xbox fanboys are grasping anything they get their hands on to keep themselves above water. I know they are. And the Xbox fanboys are like circling around and say, this is a year of Xbox. Xbox for the win. And I'm like, give it up. And you lost the first battle. You lost a major war, and that was the first year. Just, set up for second place and be happy with it. Because the Wii U actually surpassed the Xbox. For me, I think about a month. So actually, Xbox lost the Wii U for about a month, or a couple weeks anyway, though. So it's kind of funny, though, that the fanboys, again, once again, they are morphing into action and becoming my immortal hate fanboy rangers, running around talking about how the Xbox for the win, but yet they can't prove it because the Xbox games themselves are not at 1080p except Halo 1 through 4, and hopefully Halo 5 better be 1080p, because when I get Halo 1 4, that better be the best game. I already played 1 through 3 campaign and 4 as well, too. But I haven't played 2, 4 with campaign, and I haven't played online on 2. And her 1's gonna be good, too, online as well. So, I'm getting that game this year. It's just one of those things. Just one of the things you gotta deal with, Nothing that's, unavoidable. It's 100% understandable, technically, with stuff going on around here, with the games, stuff they're coming out, and how 2014 has been the year of the tax write-off, what Stone Fox says, and he had to be right, though, about it, because it is a write-off. But given this whole thing, looking at the Xbox One, how bad it's been for the last 9 months, they have to come around and do something, because they're not gonna beat the 10-15 million that PS4 is. No, they're not going to, not this year. Maybe next year they make it 10 million. Maybe in January, February, they make it 10 million. That'd be good for them. But if Sony's at 15-20 million at a point in time, it's over with. The gloves are off. Ding 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 ding. Call PS for the winner and call it a day. Go back home and sit back down, because PS4 needs a go home to drunk. Because the Xbox fanboys and the Xbox One crew calling you bastards out too on Facebook and YouTube. The Xbox One crew feeding people like Frederick, feeding these people this crap, telling them how Xbox will win. And you guys need to understand that Xbox needs to focus on games. How you gonna win a game? If Xbox games. Peace out.